Hello, Dr. Allen here again. We are on our second horizontal brain slice. So this will be block number 9. And as you remember from the previous video, the block 12 was more superior. So we were cutting higher up. With this one, we're going to catch a slice that is just a bit inferior to the previous one. So somewhere around in here. All right, so block 9. I can still see anterior versus posterior because I see that deep portion of the longitudinal fissure that helps me to tell posterior here. But this slice can be a bit tricky because it has a lot more detail. So you need to be able to figure out top versus bottom. In order to do that, I look for my open spaces, the ventricles, and the areas that connect them. So in this view, I can see open spaces happening in parallel in both of the cerebral hemispheres. So these must be lateral ventricles in the view. If I flip it over, I can still see some of the lateral ventricles, so we still see open spaces in parallel, but hey, now there's a new open space in view, and it's right in the middle of the brain, right in the middle of the diencephalon. That must be the third ventricle. So we know the third ventricle is lower than most of the lateral ventricles, so this is the bottom of this slice. Here's our top. In this view, I can still find left and right cerebral hemispheres. I can still see, if I look closely, I can still see the cortex with its gray matter versus white matter within it. We've already found lateral ventricles. We don't really have the best view of corpus callosum on this one, so I'm going to skip that. But if you remember, lateral ventricles connect to the third ventricle with the interventricular foramina. Remember, inter means between, so interventricular between the ventricles, and foramina, just holes. Well, if I look closely, I can see it almost looks like there's this little pinpoint of a hole happening right here. And I can see a similar thing occurring within the other lateral ventricle. So those are the two interventricular foramina. In order to find other features, I'm going to flip the block over. And now in this view, I am seeing even more detail, much better detail. So the next thing on our list is the insula. Remember, that is one of the lobes within the cerebrum. I always remember it's the insula. It begins with in because it's inside all of the others. And remember, the cerebrum has gyri wrinkles. So you'll see these very obvious bulges occurring at the edges of all of the lobes of the cerebrum. So if I can find those bulges, those wrinkles with their gyri inside of others, that tells me I'm looking at a different lobe. This is the insula here. We see a similar effect happening over here, wrinkles within wrinkles. So we have insula over here as well. Caudate and lentiform nuclei are areas of gray matter embedded within the white matter. So they're not going to be out here at the cortex. And this is new. You did not have to identify this on the plastic stuff. So what I always do to find them is I look more toward the anterior portion of the brain, kind of toward the middle, but more toward the anterior side than posterior. And I can see it looks like there's some gray matter happening here closer to the middle of the cerebrum. And if I look really closely, I can see there's this little line of white matter that looks like it's separating gray matter from even more gray matter over here. So this little area of gray matter is going to be the caudate nucleus and the somewhat triangular portion just behind it is the lentiform nucleus. I can see a similar effect within the other hemisphere, caudate and lentiform nuclei. You're gonna take it back out, that's fine. Thank you. All right, in this view, we can also still see third ventricle as we saw before. And if I look really closely, I can still see, that pinpoint of an open space where that interventricular foramen is helping to connect the third ventricle to one of the lateral ventricles. In this view, I can also see, it's not the greatest view of it, but I can see the pineal gland hanging off the back of the diencephalon. We aren't quite low enough to find the midbrain yet, so we'll have to move to the next brain slice for that one. So we're done with block 9, moving on to block 10 next.